I'm always trying to figure out how to make house concerts feel like concerts and not like you're playing in somebody's front room. Sometimes it's hard to create that performance vibe when you're in somebody's house and there's strangers sitting beside each other in overstuffed couches. It depends on the house concert and how familiar the audience is with the venue, the house, and each other.
Hi, is this your home?
It is.
I'm Steven.
I'm Gail.
Gail?
Doug.
Doug, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Who's the dog?
Sometimes it feels like you're playing a private party. Sometimes it feels really weird, like you're playing a private party and nobody knows each other.
So this is where we're playing, huh?
And occasionally it feels like a concert.
Thanks a lot.
Hold me like the way that you said, not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed and we will find our way over in the morning. Find our way over in the morning. Hold me like the way that you said, not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed and we will find our way over in the morning. Find our way over in the morning. Remember when I said I was sorry? Remember when I made you cry? Remember when the lights went out? We were looking for a little bit of blue sky. Looking for a little bit of blue sky. Hold me like the way that you said, not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed. We will find our way over in the morning. Find our way over. A stolen moment passes, not a day goes creeping by. Watch the world behind our glasses, looking for a little bit of blue sky. Looking for a little bit of blue sky. Hold me like the way that you said, not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed and we will find our way over in the morning. We'll find our way. Looking thinner, all my friends got an axe to grind. Making music with the sinners, looking for a blue sky. Looking for a blue sky. Looking for a blue sky. Hold me like the way that you said, not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed. We will find our way over in the morning. Not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed and we will find our way over in the morning. Find our way over in the morning. Hold me like the way that you said. Not like you were holding another. Take me to the foot of your bed. We will find our way over in the morning. We'll find our way over in the morning. We'll find our way over.
when I started, when I was a young fellow in Ireland, picking up the guitar for the first time and learning, you know, Homeward Bound and whatever my mother had in her collection, and I was starting to learn that, and then at the same time, a bunch of Neil Young stuff and what we were listening to. And my sister, who had left home ahead of me, came back, so I would have been 15. She came back from Canada with a copy of Hobo's Taunt, Willie P's fantastic record. And I knew nothing about him, but you know, she said, I know you're interested in music, and this guy's pretty hot in Canada and might interest you. And so I just learned them. You know, I put it in my collection beside ABBA, The Clash, and Boney M. And when I finally came back to Canada and started working in the coffee houses, and I realized, oh, all these people know these songs as well, so I play a few of them in my set. Got to know Willie. He became a friend and a mentor. If you were playing the folk circuit and the coffee house circuit, but you didn't necessarily embrace it wholeheartedly, shall we say, or if you had authority issues, then Willie was the guy whose music you wanted to be playing. He was sort of the anti-Stan Rogers in a way.
Do you guys mind if I play a couple of Willie P. Bennett songs? You guys know Willie P. Bennett's music, yeah? Some of you do, maybe some of you don't. This will be a little primer for you. Perhaps the greatest love song written. Willie wrote this apparently when he was working in an undergarment factory. The title is Lace and Pretty Flowers. Got lace and pretty flowers to give your baby, get her under your powers. If you got silks, sweet perfumes, you know she might come up to your room. You got love and a deep devotion that gets just as deep as the ocean with just you two inside. With just you two inside. Got satins, lots of money, diamond rings and such things to trap your honey. You got big black cars, you want to let her ride. You give it all to her, she might come over to your side. But if she's got soul, she knows she's gonna bowl you over. And when my baby rolls me over, I feel like I wanna fly. Yes, I feel like I wanna fly. In the country, you give it all to her, but she could still be empty. And you could be the richest man in the world. There's nothing I know of that'll buy you the heart of a girl. But if you got love and a deep devotion. It gets just as deep as the ocean with just you two inside. With just you two inside. With just you two inside. With just you two inside.
My mother's gonna hate that I'm smoking on camera. All right, jackets. What do you got that's like a summer jacket?
This is the coat that Tom Cruise wore in Mission Impossible 2.
Better not get that one.
This is the ones George Clooney wore in Ocean's 13, except in black. And it's got 12% stainless steel in it.
Uh-huh.
They call it full metal jacket. So
great.
You can basically rub it with a rock and it won't, you know, it's a lifetime.
I do a lot of that.
I've had my entire day scrutinized. They said to me that we want to get some footage for our B-roll of A Day in the Life of Stephen Fearing. So I said, okay, well, let's get in the car and drive to Winnipeg and back and eat hamburgers. How's that?
I write when I'm driving because I get a lot of writing ideas when I'm driving, like lots of them. And you can't pull over all the time because you'd never get where you're going. But a large chunk of my songs have been written while I'm driving. Or at least the idea. So I got a big pad of paper beside me and a Sharpie. And yeah, you don't want to be doing it when you're in traffic or, you know, driving through the Rockies, but... And there's something about, as soon as you pull off, the idea starts to disappear, or the intensity of it starts to disappear. So there's something about the act of driving that you're doing something. It's like being half awake. I phone my answering machine when I get melodic ideas, but I think I'm like a lot of people. I actually have a bit of a weird thing about my own voice. I mean, how many times do you record your answering machine message? And when you do it, do you like do 6 takes or 10? Yeah, I think we all have. Hi. No. Hi, you've reached, you know, when you get a lyric idea, it's elusive and it's so fragile. So you get home and you listen to yourself spouting some sort of purple prose nonsense into a phone with the wind noise. And it's like, no, that's not inspiring in the slightest. erase.
So have any of you ever lived beside the neighbor from hell? Or maybe you are the neighbor from hell. You don't seem like the type. I did. I lived beside the neighbor from Hades for 8 years. And police were called on many occasions. I actually had an OPP officer who came by the house to discuss an issue with a fence who took me aside and said, listen, I know they're crazy and you know they're crazy, but you have to deal with the fence. However, if they ever come on your property, shoot them. Okay, officer, thanks for the advice. On the day that they moved, my partner and I sat up in the attic with large tumblers of scotch and toasted every ratty stick of furniture that came out of that house. It was just like, thank you. And then the skies opened and hailstones the size of dogs fell on their exposed heads. And I was a believer after that. It was magnificent. It's like, get him! But then, I'm Canadian, right? So then there was this feeling of remorse. And, oh, you know, suddenly it's like this magic marker just starts to erase everything. You go, well, maybe they're not such bad people after all. So out of guilt, I started on this song. It's called Blind Indifference. train tracks run parallel and never shall they meet. You and I are two sides of the same suburban street. We share the same religion, we hum the same old song, and we learn to keep our distance, and we never get along. Oh, mercy, won't you come and shine your love on me, and take this blind indifference and make me see all the good around me, all the friends that keep me clean. Human beings were never born to be so mean. The cost of happiness is rising like the stink of gasoline, blowing down the highway from the trucks and the limousines. In the streets, the tempers and the V8 pistons fly. Curses flung like bottles at the endless passerby. Oh, mercy, won't you shine your love on me, and take this blind indifference and make me see all the good around me, all the friends that keep me clean. 'Cause human beings were never born to be so mean. I've been thinking about my father, thinking about his son, caught between what could have been and the things that we should have done. Sometimes I think the only thing that keeps you from someone is the pride you never lost and the respect that you never won. Oh, mercy, won't you come and shine your love on me, and take this blind indifference and make me see all the good around me, all the friends that keep me clean. 'Cause human beings were never born to be so mean. Oh, mercy, oh, won't you shine your love on me, and take this blind indifference and make me see all the good around me, all the friends that keep me clean. Human beings were never born to be so mean. Human beings were never born to be so mean. Human beings were never born to be so mean. Thank you. Thank you.
It's my uncle.
There's been a bunch of musicians, friends and acquaintances, and I think it's a time of life I'm at. People I know and care a lot about are passing away, so this is an appropriate song for Jeff Healey, Willie P. Bennett, Richard Bell. This is an old Irish song, and Bob Dylan stole it, turned it into a song called Restless Farewell. It's a beautiful song.
And I sort of stole the melody back and added into the old lyrics. The parting glass. Since it falls into my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and softly call good night and joy be with you all. Parting glass.